वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह। यू आर वॉचिंग सिक टीवी। आई एम सरबजीत कौर। लेट्स बिगिन द बुलेटिन विद द टॉप हेडलाइंस। कैप्टन गवर्नमेंट मेड लीकर चीपर इन पंजाब। यूनियन होम मिनिस्टर राजनाथ सिंह अनवील्ड शहीद उधम सिंह स्टैचू इन जलियांवाला बाग। विलेजर्स ऑफ मानोचाहल विलेज ऑफ तरन तारण अपोज गुरुद्वारा टेक ओवर बाय 40 persons। 6 विलेजर्स वर इंजर्ड इन ओपन फायरिंग। Farmers hold panchayat in New Delhi to press government for acceptance of their demands. Executive Director of US Basic Foundation International has initiated a hashtag campaign to pay homage to exceptional Sikh woman. Punjab High Court did not permit Paramjit Singh Peora to meet his mother. 9 CRPF personnels were killed after Maoist blew up their mine protected vehicle in Chhattisgarh. Following malfunctioning in engines, Indigo and Go Air cancelled 70 flights. Now let's begin with the detailed news. The Congress government announced the breaking of monopoly of big distillers cum contractors in Punjab's booming liquor trade. Besides reducing the quota of country-made liquor, Indian-made foreign liquor and beer to be sold in Punjab by 32%. As a result, Captain government hopes to see a correction in the prices of liquor, which had increased substantially last year after the entire business was monopolized by the powerful liquor lobby. To break the monopoly in liquor trade, the government has increased the number of groups from 84 this year to 900 in the coming fiscal. The size of the group has been fixed at a maximum of Rs. 5 crore with variation of up to 25%. Each group will have a maximum of 2 liquor vans. Exactly 78 years after Shaheed Udham Singh gunned down Michael O'Dwyer, Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh unveiled the martyr statue at the entrance of the memorial in Jallianwala Bagh. Rajnath Singh stated that the statue was an initiative of the International Sarv Kamboj Samaj to pay homage to Shaheed Udham Singh, who belonged to Kamboj community. Highlighting the central government's plan to improve infrastructure at Jallianwala Bagh, he said the centenary of the massacre would be observed by the entire nation for at least a year. Condemning the vandalization of statues of dignitaries across the country, Rajnath Singh said that the state governments had been directed to initiate stern action against the culprits. A group of 40 persons opened fire in Manochahal Kalan village in Taran Taran, who were protesting against a move to take over the village Gurdwara. 6 residents of the village were injured. Police registered case against armed men and women. The armed group led by Ranjot and Jaswinder allegedly pushed Granthi Hardeep Singh out of Gurdwara and then announced from the public address system that they had taken possession of the shrine. Ranjot and Jaswinder also said if anybody dared to oppose them. President of Gurdwara committee said villagers started heading towards the Gurdwara on hearing the announcement. Seeing this, the armed group opened fire on villagers. Farmers organized a Kisan Panchayat under Bharatiya Kisan Union in New Delhi on Monday to press for acceptance of their demands, and subsequently their delegation met Vice President Venkaiah Naidu. The well-attended panchayat comprising farmers mostly from Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh and Delhi passed a resolution asking the union government to accept their charter of 15 demands. Besides complete waiver of farm debt, their other demands include MSP for all crops, long-term interest-free loans for agriculture and ban on GM crops. Sonia Dhami, the executive director of US Basic Foundation International, has initiated a hashtag campaign to pay homage to exceptional Sikh women. In a Facebook post, she has written, "March is Women's History Month and an apt time to honor the remarkable women from Sikh history. Many are faceless in our collective public memories, but they are certainly not nameless. Their exemplary achievements are recorded in history, though not celebrated enough. They were leaders who stood up to aggression and resisted powerful opponents, holding steadfastly to their feminine strengths." The women mentioned by Chandigarh-born Dhami include Mai Fatto, wife of Baba Ala Singh of Patiala, Rajinder Kaur of Fagwada, and Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh Smother Maharani Mohinder Kaur. She named Ratan Kaur, Sada Kaur, Ram Kaur, and Dya Kaur among those who resisted the might of the line of Punjab. Sonia Dhami has called on artists to fill in the faces of these remarkable women and help keep their inspiring stories alive. Well, this is all what we have in this edition. Stay tuned for more updates, and again, let's have a look on news headlines. Captain government made liquor cheaper in Punjab. Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh unveiled Shaheed Udham Singh statue in Jallianwala Bagh. Villagers of Manochahal village of Taran Taran opposed Gurdwara takeover by 40 persons. 6 villagers were injured in open firing. Farmers hold panchayat in New Delhi to press government for acceptance of their demands. Executive Director of US Basic Foundation International has initiated a hashtag campaign to pay homage to exceptional Sikh woman. Punjab High Court did not permit Paramjit Singh Peora to meet his mother. 9 CRPF personnels were killed after Maoist blew up their mine protected vehicle in Chhattisgarh. Following malfunctioning in engines, Indigo and Go Air cancelled 70 flights.